Hello everyone, it's Komar Finn here, and in this video we'll be doing the trailer analysis of Top Gun Maverick. Just for those of you who are not familiar with my channel, I mainly do trailer analysis for video games like Ace Combat, hence my username. But this is the first time we're doing for a movie. It's a little bit different because there are some story considerations and I'm more familiar with Ace Combat. But anyway, let's get going with the analysis, and I already assume you already watched the trailer by yourself, of course, because I started analyzing from the very beginning. But anyway, let's get going. Official trailer. First thing I want to mention right here in the beginning, this is most likely the China Lake area. I believe it's in Nevada. It's a place where the US Navy, they test new weapons. How do I know, or I believe, that it is China Lake? I'll explain as we go.
30 plus years of service. Combat medals, citations. Only man to shoot down 3 enemy planes in the last 40 years.
Alright, that's going pretty fast, almost 600 knots. That's almost breaking the sound barrier, which I believe it's illegal, unless they have authorization from the military. But that speaks to the character of Maverick. Also, another thing to notice on the F-18, this is not your standard F-18 paint scheme. You can see that it's black, blue and red and black right here just under the canopy. That's just so you know you're watching the movie, you can identify, okay, that guy's Maverick. And you see it's a 00, it's a number.
Yet you can't get a promotion, you won't retire. Despite your best efforts, you refuse to die.
I believe this is the only indication of like a modern technology, because you know the F-18 is pretty old. It's a pretty old airplane. But I still haven't figured out quite yet when the movie takes place, like, you know, if it's in real life. I mean, real life, like, you know, these days, or back in the 90s or early 2000s. There's a historical theory why it should have been in the 90s. I'll explain it as we go. And the style, yeah, it's very different. I think it's the same director that made Tron, so here you go. Okay, I thought it was really cool, this part of the cinematography, you know, the elevator going up, and it's dark, so you can't see, but then it reveals the characters. That was pretty cool.
At least a 2-star admiral by now. Yet here you are. Captain. Why is that?
Alright, a couple things to notice here. Look at this round thing. That's part of his suit. Now, if you look closely, it's a little bit dirty. There's like some dust or sand. It's easier to spot as we in the other parts that we see, but it's a little bit dusty. It looks like his forehead here on the left side, it's also a little bit dusty, which my theory is he just came back from a mission. And he wouldn't be dirty if the mission went as planned, so either something happened to this plane or he has to be rescued or something. That's just my theory.
One of life's mysteries, sir.
I don't think so. Just a minor, just the new emblem on his helmet. I don't think it was there in the first movie. It's like a dragon, I think, or a bird. Now, a couple things to notice. I think there's an F-18 ready to take off as well, just waiting for him. And I'm not sure if this Hawkeye is getting ready to take off to provide, you know, AWACS support, or it just came back and they're just stowing it and putting it back for storage, right? Because the wings are folded. Now, things to notice, I believe it's a sidewinder on the two outer hard points. But under here, I thought it was interesting, is he's carrying 2 bombs. I believe it's the GBU-24. It's a laser-guided bomb for, you know, ground targets. I can see here, that's the GBU that it is. And yeah, very interesting. And you're gonna see these bombs later on in other scenes as well. So just keep that in mind. He's both air to air and air to ground ordnance. This is the part of the trailer that I would say, you know, just invoking the flashbacks from the first Top Gun. So you're gonna see lots of references, and this is especially targeting like Miramar. That's where they had the first Top Gun was established in San Diego, California. So sunny. All right, lots of stuff going on right here. You can see in his a lot of patches. These are from like real life squadrons, I believe most of them. And here's his fictional emblem. It's the same like kind of bird or dragon that you see in his helmet. Now, I know the visually things are very it's very cluttered here, but important to notice there's a picture of I believe it's a woman. Not sure if the same woman they had in the first movie. I don't know. Maybe they broke off or another one. So, and it's important because it's on eye level. So it must have some importance to Maverick. Now, some interesting things to notice right here. Okay, it's very hard to get the frame, but I think if you look at the very first frame of this scene, this reads test pilot. I'm not gonna go back because it's a bit hard to find here on the mic player, but I already checked test pilot. The rest I can't read. It's too blurry. Okay, on the reflection of his glasses, you can see this light. It's very tall. That indicates he's probably in a hangar. That's why it's so tall. That implies Maverick has a lot of money to have his own hangar, so to put all his storage, and he might have a plane for himself as well. And this part, I believe it looks like, you know, on the stand, as if it was like some part of a metal, like from an aircraft, maybe like a historic something he collected. Maybe that's why he's on this plaque or something, like a test pilot for this plane or whatever. And he not only has one set pair of glasses, he has another one. So is that his? Could you have action, or is it somebody else you share your hangar with? Another thing to notice here, right here on the picture frame, I believe that's him. And the aircraft he's around is the F-117 Nighthawk. How do I know it's a Nighthawk? The way the canopy opens up, the type of the shape, triangular. The color most likely black, because it's pretty dark, and the shadow gives a hint too. So in the first movie, at the end, he said he wanted to be an instructor at Top Gun. So maybe he was that good that he got an opportunity to be a test pilot as well. And now let's go. See, he's in a hangar. You can see it. The walls are very high. And apparently he likes having a lot of motorbikes. Good for him. There's a flag. I don't know what the flag is about, by the way. If someone knows, please tell me. There you go. I think it's the same motorbike he had in the first movie. Things to notice. Patch. This is the Top Gun patch. And this is the VX-1 patch. The VX-31 patch. It's a real-life squadron. Base where? China Lake. And where they test weapons for the U.S. Navy. And you can if you... I know it's a bit hard to see here, but if you look on Wikipedia, thanks Wikipedia, that's the emblem. They're known as the Dust Devils, yeah. Okay, so apparently Maverick went there as well. Yeah, thanks Wikipedia, very helpful. Seeing the plane taking off. This we can identify already as the Miramar, I think, air base in San Diego. That's where Top Gun was... took place in the first movie in real life. But the thing is, historically, Top Gun moved from that airbase to Nevada in 1996. Now, if this was to be in real life, it couldn't be the same, because historically it moved. So maybe for, you know, the movie's universe, it's different from real life, so maybe Top Gun stayed there, which is what my theory is at the moment. Here's the interesting part. That's where, remember when I said the suit, the round thing? This is not your regular fighter pilot helmet. It's clearly not. It's more like a high altitude, almost like an astronaut kind of helmet. It's like for, you know, places with really low pressure. And I couldn't quite figure out what plane his is in. Because I already mentioned, you already seen the Nighthawk. So okay, maybe that's the Nighthawk. It's not. If you see, look at how it is, the canopy, as it opens up. The fuselage is very low compared to the pilot, so it's not a Nighthawk. It couldn't be the Nighthawk. Okay, it's maybe it's the Blackbird. Okay, it's kind of the same thing. The fuselage is higher, but right here where it changes to the front, it keeps on going, the metal piece, while in the movie it keeps on going and then stops. Right here, just about it stops. So it's not the Blackbird. Okay, maybe it's like U2. Then again, the cockpit doesn't match. So I was like, okay, what could this be? Because I couldn't really identify. If you don't know the airplane, let me know. Because it looks like a high altitude, hence the helmets. Looks like it's for night operations, hence it looks like it's painted black. And so it's most likely for like a night recon. Now there is a possibility this could be the Nighthawk N, which is a version that the Navy was offered from the Nighthawk to be able to land on carriers, but it never existed in real life. So again, it's a movie, it might be different from real life, of course. But again, if you don't know the airplane, let me know. Alright, Fighter Town, the always famous control tower in Miramar. You see the guy's probably looking for his thing. He's like, oh, that's Maverick's plane, 00. And they can see the paints, black, blue, black. And then behind him, you see another Hornet, 410. Okay, you're gonna see this other airplane again later in the movie. Volleyball, of course. No, that's American football with the ball. Sports, very important. Top Gun's promoting a healthy lifestyle. It just references to the, I guess, previous movie, the Navy culture, that kind of thing. I didn't spot anything in this part. All right, this airplane, is that a P-51? We believe, roughly from the shape. And was that stored in Maverick's hangar? Because we saw the hangar, it's a little bit of wooden. I suppose it's his personal, so does he own a plane himself? He looks like he's rich, because he has a hangar, so... Besides having bikes, lots of bikes, he might have a plane as well. That would not surprise me, honestly. And somewhere in the middle of California, probably. And then we have a Phoenix, apparently. It's going to be one of his buddies. She's going to be an F-18 pilot, most likely. You can see behind, it's probably the sea, and you can see in the reflection on her helmet. You can see some planes and the carrier and the sea, so... I didn't notice anything in these parts. Someone's gonna die. following the tradition of Goose, someone's gonna die. I thought that this could potentially be a flashback to Goose dying, because his funeral wasn't shown in the previous movie. But Maverick has way too many medals to be a flashback, so... Yeah. Press F. Now, what did I say about the planes before? That's the plane, the 410. So the plane that was in Top Gun was also in the carrier. And that's, of course, Maverick's planes. And you can see it's still carrying the laser-guided bombs for his mission. Now, here's a very interesting scene, like cinematography-wise. That's really cool. Now we get an idea of where this is taking place. First of all, vegetation. You see, very high trees, like those cones. I think, how's it called in English? Is it called taiga forest? I think it's how it's called. And second of all, it's a lot of snow. So what we can gather from this, this is a really elevated latitude, like in the map. It could be really low, but no one cares about the Southern Hemisphere, honestly. So it's probably, there's only a few countries where this could be, United States, Canada, maybe not even the United States, depends on the area, but Canada, Russia, and some parts of Europe. Now the interesting thing is that these planes are going pretty fast. You can tell that by the condensation, and they're carrying bombs. They're still carrying the bombs, and they're flying below the tree line. Wouldn't be like a almost like if they were trying to evade a radar from detecting them. That's my theory right now. And they also have the panel, they still have their tanks, so for a long range mission. And they're not like totally loaded as well. So they're pretty fast and agile. Right, let's get going. Okay, now we have another hint of where this takes place. So high elevation, the taiga kind of forest, and also high like mountains with snow. So you get an idea. Now the way he is maneuvering right here, you can see he's still carrying the bombs. Gotta carry those bombs. But you see, he goes just above the mountain and he dives real fast. Now, yes, it could be a training mission where someone is chasing him, but my theory is he's trying to avoid radar, because you know, if there's a mountain and you're right here and the radar's on the other side, the radar won't pick you up. It'll only pick you up when you're above the mountain. But then if you dive back, maybe you can evade it somehow.
The end is inevitable, Maverick. Your kind is headed for extinction.
Now, when it comes to the overall theme of the movie, I think this could be a hint, like, you know, your kind is in extinction. What do you mean? Like, kind of like aggressive pilot or like actual human pilot? Because a lot of speculation was Top Gun 2 or Top Gun Maverick would be, you know, human pilots against drones, which is almost like Ace Combat 7, you know. But we haven't seen any indication of like a hyper advanced aircraft other than the one that we still don't know, or drones. And we haven't even seen the F-35, which was very surprising. Instead, we've seen the F-18. Anyway, his regular helmet.
Headed for extinction.
Maybe so, sir.
And then, now we see. Remember I said it was dirty? It's easier to see this time. It's either dirt or sand or dust or something like that. You can see it's almost like, my theory is he was with that unknown aircraft. Something went wrong in the mission. I'm not sure if he got damaged or he had to eject from the aircraft. But he was rescued, and as he's debriefing the whoever his commander is. But yeah, he's still there. He's wearing his special flight suit.
But not today.
I'm gonna get all the information. And cameo of the F-14. Now, the F-14 has retired since a long time ago, so either the US kept some or it's Iran. Iran is behind everything. But it doesn't really match the scenery. As far as I know, I might be wrong, but Iran doesn't have... Okay, Iran has mountains. High mountains. But I don't think Iran is that green, if you know what I'm saying. It to me, doesn't match the location with Iran. So, right now, my move here is... Maverick, he became a test pilot, maybe helped with Top Gun as well, because he can do both, multi-role. But then he went with this reconnaissance mission, ninth reconnaissance mission, something went wrong, they discovered something important, and maybe they have to strike it with the air-to-ground bombs that we seen the planes carrying. I think it was a little bit below, like in this scene. Now, where could this take place? Okay. Going to the United States, like Alaska, Canada, that wouldn't make any sense, you know. So, it would be either Russia or some parts in Europe. Now, I don't think it would be some parts in Europe. So, let's blame Russia. Because, you know, this is a movie. I know it's Top Gun's mostly focused on mock dogfights, at least the first one was. But you gotta have some real action. You gotta destroy some stuff. Which they did in the movie. Wasn't that much, but they did. Now, no, From what I gather, I believe I found one place where this could happening with the hints that we've been having it. And so take a look at this map. This is a map that I think tracks Russia's military units. Well, of course, everything mostly in Europe. But I found something interesting. You know, just across Alaska, right, or the Americas on this peninsula here. There's quite a lot of facilities that I believe this is where the movie would take place. You know, they can always find excuses on why the Russians are bad, like, you know, some rebel units or something out of control or something like that. So there's an airbase, there is an anti-aircraft, like a missile regiment protected by the S-400, good quality protection right there, infantry brigade, and a naval port, which I believe includes some like nuclear submarines. Yeah, nuclear-powered attack submarines. It's a very cool map. I'll have put the link in the description, because you want to take a look. And there is also some artillery. So, a lot of different targets, and ground targets, right? Remember, because they're still carrying bombs. Now, this matches with the scenery because it's Russia. It's cold. Like, it's a high latitude. And there are some mountains. It's kind of hard to see it from here, from this type of map. But if you look at Google Maps in this area, you can see there's a lot of volcanoes. There are high mountains, which matches with them, you know, going with what we've seen in the trailer. And the vegetation, I believe it matches as well. It's very green. I believe the trees are very high. So if I had to guess where they are going with those bombs, I would guess right here. And if you recall, in Modern Warfare 2, this is the same place where you invade to go for the nuclear submarine. The same location. I believe, yeah. The rest of the coast, there's a few air bases, but as far as I know, no major ports or anything. The rest of this part is too close to Japan or something. Because, you know, you can always say that the U.S. aircraft carriers are around here in the Bering Sea, because the States has several islands, so they can move there without alerting the Russians. But anyway, that's my theory right now on Top Gun Maverick, the movie. Anyway, hope you guys have enjoyed. This is the first time I do an analysis for a movie. I just thought it was interesting. And if you guys enjoy it, then I might make more, because I'm most likely focused on video games. But I thought it was interesting, because it's Top Gun. But anyway, let me know what you guys think. If I missed something, let me know in the comments as well, because I usually do. Lots of details. And of course, it's a bit early to tell, because it's the only first trailer of the movie, but I enjoy doing that kind of stuff. Anyway, let me know what you guys think. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you guys next time.